Good afternoon, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath, as always, I hope you're having a blessed and peaceful Sabbath day. Shabbat Shalom. Now, this first video I'm going to do today, I hope to do several, but this first one is in response to a comment that was left to me on the video I did last week about character. And in like, I responded with a comment, and then the young lady responded back with another comment. So I said, well, let me do a video on really both of these and put this out as an informative study, as I do, so that other people can hear what's going on and some can learn from it, some can agree or some can disagree, whatever. They're an opinion, they're comments, that's what they're there for. But the question is, the young lady wrote, she said, I like this, but where's the basis? Scripture, please. And the video I did last week was about character. And simply put, I stated in no uncertain terms that when we die, the state that we die in spiritually, that's the state we're going to be raised in. If we die unrighteously, we're going to be raised unrighteously. The Father is not going to change our character once He raises us. We die in the state we're in. If we live an unrighteous life and die unrighteously, that's the state we're in. If we live a righteous life and die righteously, that's the state we're in. The only thing that He is going to change at the resurrection are those righteous children that He raises from the graves. He's going to change these bodies into an incorruptible body. Because remember, the new children, once He raises them and changes them, they're going to go off to live in heaven, that eternal life, that promise. See, we can't think, like I always say, we can't think that we're going to be able to live here now doing any and everything, every sinful thing you can think of, living any way we want, and think that the Father is going to change us. We have instructions to our life now. We live a probationary life. This life we're living right now, all of you watching, this is a probationary life. We have to form this life and our character the way it needs to be when we die, so that we can be raised righteously. This is why the Father gives us free will. He forces none of us to do anything. We have instructions, we have wisdom, we have all these things from heaven to help us. The Savior came as an example and showed us what we need to do. But yet, people still believe that they can live their lives any way they want, committing all the sinful things they want, living any kind of way they want, doing all the kind of things they want, and they keep thinking they're going to have opportunity. But before they blink, they can't. They're dead in the grave, unrighteously, and that's how the Father's going to raise them. But they're going to be raised after He raises His righteous children, and then those which are alive, He's going to raise them, and then the wicked are going to be risen. But that was the young lady's response. So this is how I responded to her. First, go with me to 1 Thessalonians 4:16. And it reads, it says, for the Lord Himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and the voice of the archangel, and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. The dead in Christ shall rise first. Now, I'm not going to make any presumptions. I would say that this means that the dead who are righteous, which I just talked about, those who are in Christ and died that way, that's who this is referring to. They're going to be raised first. Now, they would have had to been righteous when they died to be righteous when He comes back. Simply put, thus, those who are dead in Christ are referred to by this statement. Then it continues in verse 17, and verse 17 says what? It says, then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall ever be with the Lord. This is the living who are in Christ. Now remember, when He comes, there are going to be some alive, just like today if He came right now. There are some of us who are alive that are righteous. We're not going to have to face death. What a blessing. Some of us are not ever going to have to die if He comes while we're alive and we're righteous. But this is referring to those righteous ones who are alive right now, or when He comes. They will be raised after the dead in Christ are raised, and they all will meet Him in the clouds. Now, the dead in Christ first, then the living, and Christ shall go. But go to 2 Thessalonians 2:8, and it reads like this. And then shall the wicked be revealed, when the Lord shall consume them with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy them with the brightness of his coming. Okay, now you may ask, how are the wicked revealed? First, what just happened? He removed the dead in Christ from off this earth, and then those which were alive, he removed them off this earth. So what's left? He removed all his righteous children. The only thing left are the wicked or unrighteous. That's how they are revealed. See, scripture is very simple and clear, but you have to study it, and you have to have wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and common sense to put it together and let it all come together. If he removes all the righteous, nothing's left but unrighteous or wicked. That is how they are revealed, and that's why 2 Thessalonians 2:8 says what it says. They're revealed in that way. Now, the unrighteous, wicked, sinners, whatever you would like to call them, they are revealed by virtue of all the righteous being removed out of the way. And the word says what? That they will be consumed by the brightness of his coming. Now, if you go to Revelation 24, it tells us, and they lived and reigned with Christ 1,000 years. Now, this is referring to who? The righteous. He didn't take anybody else with him. See, it's simple, people. Every single detail does not have to be spelled out in scripture. It's knowledge, is wisdom. You have to be wise. You have to study so that discernment comes upon you to say, oh, that makes sense. If he just consumed all the unrighteous with the breath of his coming, and he took the righteous with him, there's nothing with him but righteous. Now, so back to Revelations, it says, this is referring to the righteous. And those unrighteous were what? Consumed by the brightness of his coming, and explained in Revelation 25, but the rest of the dead lived not again until 1,000 years were finished. Now, this is the first resurrection. What rest of the dead? All those that he just consumed with the breath of his coming, and all the ones who were already dead, all the unrighteous. Remember, all the righteous are alive now, and they're with him. They've been changed to glorified bodies, and they're with him. So, that was my response to that, and I put, be blessed, Brother Lloyd. And I presume that would be satisfactory in some sense, but once again, I got another response, and the second response said this: thank you for explaining, but aren't we made righteous in Christ the moment we accept him as our Lord and Savior? For example, what if a smoker is dying from lung cancer? Someone comes to preach the gospel to that person and they decide to accept Christ, but dies the next day, unable to quit smoking. Are you saying he'll have that habit in heaven? We'll find out. This is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.